That was for Sandra. I met her earlier, and she wanted to hear that song. She likes that song. There's an amazing group of women here from Mercy Ministries. Let's give it up. Come on, Mercy Ministries. Where are you guys? There you are. And we are here for a really important cause tonight. And there's a lot of people in the world that wonder if love has failed them, and honestly feel like love has failed them. Their hearts have been broken. And as you may have heard, there's a lot of people out there who are in bondage, in slavery, and not in just like the other sense of the word, but the true sense of the word. They are slaves. They are trafficked and sold and used and abused, and it happens every day, and that it breaks my heart every day to know that it still is happening. And I was telling you earlier about Bob Goff. Bob took me to India in 2003, and that was the first time that I saw for myself with my own eyes. We were in a city called Chennai, which used to be called Madras. And I remember my first day being there, I had this really sore stomach, and I just wondered, why am I here, God? Why did you bring me here? And I remember waking up in the middle of the night and with a sore stomach, and God said, Brandon, I brought you this far, but I can't do anything with you unless you trust me. And my stomach quit hurting. I ate all the bizarre foods. I was totally fine. But I was experiencing a little bit of culture shock, but also feeling insignificant. And how could God use a guy like me? I didn't know that I was going to do this. I knew that I liked music, but I think God knew someday I would have a microphone and I could talk about what I'd seen. And what I saw were four girls, young, standing in front of what we would call a brothel. And I just wondered, can we just go rescue them? And it's just not that simple, which you think that it is, but there's this crazy, urgent need for aftercare. That's one of the big things that Three Strands is trying to provide and to bring awareness to girls and boys who live here in the U.S. so that we don't get caught up in the same trap, because we are just as desperate as they are in third world countries for love. And we have everything, don't we? We're still desperate. So what does that say? We are all looking in the wrong places, and sometimes it can be into Satan's pit, where he would just have his way with us. So I love being here tonight. And I love standing up for a cause like Three Strands. And I love what Mercy Ministries is doing for women and restorative work. And I'm just so encouraged that they're here tonight. You know, I was telling you earlier, you know, I got married, and I've never known a woman so deeply as I know my wife. And one of the things that we did before we got married is we just kind of shared our past and the things and the mistakes that we have made. And I wanted her to know, when we stood on the altar, I wanted her to know who she was saying I do to, you know? And I wanted her, when she said yes, I wanted her to mean it, you know? And so the only way that I could do that is just to share my own stuff. And if you still say yes to this, then I know that it's for real, you know? So when we did, it was just the most amazing feeling, and I made mistakes in my past, and she did too, but we met in this beautiful place of forgiveness, and Jesus is the catalyst for mercy, and hopefully we can be merciful with each other for the rest of our lives, because we still hurt each other. And when you love someone that deeply, and when you know their pain, you also know the button to push. You know, don't push that button. and hopefully she will never push my button. That's what really being in relationship with people should be, you know. I'm so thankful I found her. I'm going to sing you a song. This wasn't on my list, but I'm going to sing it anyways. This is on the new record, and this is a song that I wrote after we got married when I was less nervous about writing her a song. I just saw the girl of my dreams. I wonder if she noticed me. I don't know her name yet, but I know her friend. I'll ask if she's taken or if I could send her some flowers. I just met the girl of my dreams. It's funny, it turns out that she lives just down the street. We should go for a walk or sit on her porch drinking coffee and talking for hours. Falling in love is a beautiful thing, like every morning's the first day of spring. God must be smiling down over me. I'm in love with the girl of my dreams. So I married the girl of my dreams in a chapel in Tennessee. She looked like a princess in her wedding dress. I looked like a penguin, and I must confess, I was nervous. Now I live with the girl of my dreams. It's different than I thought it'd be. She steals all my closets and tells me I snore. It's ice cream and Netflix, and I love her more every minute. Falling in love is a beautiful thing, like every morning's the first day of spring. God must be smiling down over me. I'm in love with the girl of my dreams. Brown hair, bluish green eyes, she's southern. Strawberry pie in the summer. Holidays with our big family, thousands of memories will hang on the wall. Heartaches and laughter, yeah, I'll take it all and be thankful. Falling in love is a beautiful thing. You give up yourself, but you gain everything. She's more than a lover, she's my best friend. I'll be her companion until the end. God must be smiling down over me, cause I'm walking on clouds and moonbeams. I'm in love with the girl of my dreams.
Thank you very much.